The flu. Are you concerned about it? Let's talk about how you can protect yourself, especially from the new bugs. At the end of 2019, a brand new flu bug started to affect us, the coronavirus. It's actually related to the SARS virus, although not nearly as infectious nor as deadly. But because it started in China, in the wet market, in a highly crowded area, it spread very quickly. And because of our global travel, that virus has been able to move from continent to continent. People got pretty freaked out about this, and it happened right in the middle of flu season. At this point, there's no vaccine. It takes about a year after a virus emerges for a vaccine to actually be created. And viruses are pretty adaptable, mutating to get around our vaccines. Now, there is a herd mentality to vaccination for the flu, trying to protect the very young and the very old and those who have immune systems that are compromised. But there are other ways that you can help to protect yourself from the flu. First, you need to be aware that the flu virus can incubate anywhere from 2 to 14 days, which means that you can be exposed to the flu and not come down with it for at least 2 days to 2 weeks. Now, how can you be exposed? The flu virus actually settles in the upper respiratory passages of the nose and throat. And most of the time, people are exposed through particles in the air, usually by somebody sneezing. So unfortunately, someone infected with the flu sneezed. You could have breathed it in. The virus lands in your throat or your nose and you become infected. Now, lots of people can be exposed to the flu and not everybody gets the flu virus. Some people have such strong immune systems, much stronger than others. And there's things you can do to boost your immune system. Staying healthy by eating a diet that has a variety of colorful fruits and vegetables, making sure you're getting adequate amounts of protein and hydration can actually help to boost your immune system. I'm a big fan of elderberry as a tea or even as extract or in drops or in capsule form as a way to help to boost your immune system too, especially during flu season. Zinc lozenges and also nasal spray has been shown to help shorten the effect of the flu virus. One of the biggest ways that you can protect yourself is washing your hands. A lot of the particle matter from the flu can be picked up by your hands and then you wipe it unknowingly on your face. Yes, even if someone hasn't sneezed around you, if they sneeze somewhere in the area and the virus landed on a hard surface, like a countertop, a doorknob, a handrail, and you touched it and put it near your face, you're going to end up catching the virus. So be sure you wash your hands. Now, should we be using hand sanitizers or actual soap and water? Well, studies show that hand washing is the most effective at killing germs, and you don't even need to use soap. At least 30 seconds of vigorous scrubbing of your hands underwater can actually get the virus off your hands. The alcohol in the hand sanitizer is not enough to kill the virus. Now, there are some different essential oils, though, that actually have really interesting effects on these viruses. One is called thieves' oil. It's a combination of a few different essential oils originally developed back in the Dark Ages to combat the plague. And it does seem to have a very good effect at killing a variety of germs, including the influenza virus, especially if spraying it on fomites, or basically hard surfaces. The virus is more likely to sit on hard surfaces like metals, plastics, and glass that you might touch after somebody infected it with the flu, either sneezed on it or touched it. So can you protect yourself wearing a mask? You probably can. But if you're not washing your hands and you pull that mask off and touch your nose or mouth, you're going to infect yourself anyhow. So hand washing is key. And definitely, if you think you might be getting sick, if you've been exposed to the flu, you want to stay away from the very young, the very old, and anybody with a compromised immune system. Because while you may get sick with the flu, and it's pretty uncomfortable, with a fever and chills and body aches and coughing and generally down for the count for up to a couple of weeks, flu viruses can be deadly to a newborn, the very elderly, or someone who has a compromised immune system, like someone going through chemotherapy. So be careful not to infect others. And if you're feeling sick, and definitely if you have a fever, stay home. When you're feverish is when you're contagious. Now with the flu, you can be contagious right before your fever hits. And that can be the day before the fever hits. and you're definitely contagious until 24 hours after your fever has gone down. So don't go to work, don't go to school, don't send your kids to school if they have a fever or have had a fever within 24 hours. That's how we protect each other. We don't go to work or go to school or go to the store sick. So I know it gets scary in the flu season with all of these new bugs, and there's going to be more new bugs. These viruses have been around for way longer than we humans have, and they will keep mutating, so we must protect ourselves with excellent hand washing techniques and make sure that we're boosting our immune system with a really healthy, colorful diet. Drinking elderberry tea, making sure we're getting enough antioxidants in our fruits and vegetables, that's the way that you can protect yourself from the flu. And if you do come down with the flu, and it will happen, it happens to all of us once in a while, it just happened to me recently. It's just a reminder, I believe, of your body telling you you need to slow down and take better care of yourself. Are you getting enough sleep? Are you eating well enough? Are you trying to boost your immune system? Are you even washing your hands? It's time to take account of all the ways that you can protect yourself so you can enjoy life. So check out my next video for more health tips.